fortune from life. You saved me, you gave me something I could feel. Love is all the man who's faithful and forever, keeping us together. Love is all we need. Prisoner of illusion, sentence is suspended. Loneliness is ended, love has set me free. Tomorrow morning if you wake up and the sun does not appear, I will be here. If in the dark we lose sight of love, hold my hand and have no fear, 'cause I will be here. I will be here when you feel like being quiet, when you need to speak your mind, I will listen, and I will be here when the laughter turns to crying, through the winning and losing and trying, we'll be together, 'cause I will be. Tomorrow morning if you wake up and the future is unclear, I'll be here, just as sure as seasons are made for change, our lifetimes are made for years, and I will be here. I will be here. You can cry on my shoulder when the mirror tells us we're old. I will. I will be here. I will be here. I will be here.
face I can't forget. The trace of pleasure or regret may be my treasure or the price I have to pay. She may be the song the summer sings, maybe the chill the autumn brings, maybe a hundred different things within the measure of a day. She may be the beauty or the beast, maybe the famine or the feast, may turn each day into a heaven or a hell. She may be the mirror of my dreams, a smile reflected in a stream. She may not be what she may seem inside her shell. Allowed to see them when they cry. She may be the love that cannot hope to last, may come to me from shadows of the past that I remember till the day I die. She may be the reason I survive.
Brothers and sisters, let us all stand. The procession will begin. heaven, which is marriage. Marriage is not only one of the basic institutions upon which our society is founded, but more importantly, it is a divine institution. Therefore, we should give it due honor and respect, since it should be done with the inspiration of the Almighty God. Let us come before Him first in prayer, after the singing of a hymn.
A lifetime vow, and this vow is a governed
hence neither the man nor the woman should have power over the other of the laws and commandments of God concerning marriage. So listen now to the commandments of God to the man and to the woman who are become husband and wife through the sanctity of marriage. These are the commandments of God to the man, to you, that day. The duty of the man who is entering marriage is told by Apostle Paul, which his wife loves himself. After all, no one ever hates his own body, but he feeds and cares for it, just as Christ does the church. To help us appreciate the greatness of love, a man should give to his wife. Apostle Paul then went on to say, and the wife, as Christ is the head of the church, his body, of which he is the Savior. Thus, it is the man that God said, in the sweat of your face, you shall eat bread. To make this union of the servants of God who are being bound by his commandments a happy and peaceful one, the instruction to the man is, husbands, love your wives and do not be harsh with them. In like manner, Apostle Peter says in his epistle, husbands, in the same way be considerate as you live with your wives and treat them with respect, as the weaker partner and as heirs with you of the gracious gift of life, so that nothing will hinder your prayers. Do you understand your obligation? That who is entering marriage is also known by Apostle Paul in his epistle, admit your husbands as it is fitting in the Lord. The woman is not permitted to be the head of the man, but rather the apostles teach, let the woman learn in silence with all submissiveness. I permit no woman to teach or to have authority over men. She is to keep silent. Apostle Paul also makes known that the woman should be a model in all things, he said. Then they can train the younger woman to love their husbands and their children, to be self-controlled and pure, to be busy at home, to be kind, and to be subject to their husbands, so that no one will malign the word of God. The woman who has these qualities is extremely valuable, and the man who finds this kind woman has found a good treasure. The proverb spoken by King Solomon is fulfilled to him, a good wife who can find. She is far more precious than jewels. The heart of her husband trusts in her, and he will have no lack of gain. She does him good and not harm all the days of her life. Indeed, the woman who is being married should possess these qualities, because it is written, the woman is the glory of the man. Do you understand? Lord your God, with all your heart, with all your soul, and with all your mind. You must impart this to your children and use the commandments of God in rearing them up, for it is also written, and you shall teach them diligently to your children, and shall talk of them when you sit in your house, and when you walk by the way, and when you lie down, and when you rise. If you carefully obey, Brother Dave and Sister Raquel, all these commandments, your marriage shall surely be successful, because you will receive the blessings and the loving care of the Lord God. As what is written in the book of Psalms, blessed is everyone who fears the Lord, who walks in his ways. You shall eat the fruit of the labor of your hands. You shall be happy, and it shall be well with you. Your wife be like a fruitful vine within your house. Your children will be like olive shoots around your table. Look, thus shall be the man be blessed who fears the Lord. We who witness this momentous event fervently wish and pray that both of you would receive the abundant blessings and loving care of God Almighty to be the balm and inspiration of your union as husband and wife. Are you ready to make a sacred vow before God, which will be heard by the witnesses you have chosen in this gathering? Please, the couple, together with the primary and secondary sponsor, shall rise. The rest of the congregation, please remain seated. Brother Lee, please raise your right hand. Brother Lee, do you solemnly agree to take Sister Raquel to be your wife and swear that you will love and respect her, give her honor and love in health and in sickness, in wealth and in poverty, that though you may leave everyone else, you will remain with him so long as you would live? Please stand. Sister Raquel, please raise your right hand. Sister Raquel, do you also solemnly agree to accept Brother Dave as your husband and swear that you will live with him with full trust and affection in health and in sickness, in wealth and in poverty, that though you may leave everyone else, you will remain with him so long as you both live?
Separated by death, inasmuch
as you have promised to fulfill the commandments of God concerning marriage, and you both have agreed to fulfill these vows, I, by virtue of my authority as a minister of the gospel, pronounce that you are now true husband and wife in accordance with the commandments of the Lord God Almighty and the laws of this country. What therefore God has joined together, let not no man put asunder. Please, all of you, kneel down with your right hand joined together. The rest of the congregation, please rise and let us pray. Our Heavenly Father, you heard the sacred vows made by your two servants before you. We ask you, O Father, bless them. Bless this new couple and may their marriage be a successful one. When problems and trials come into their life, Father, help them, guide them, and hold them in your mighty right hand so that they can remain firm in their faith, remain faithful to each other, and most of all can remain faithful in serving your holy name until the end of their life.
Amen.
Bless their relatives. Bless their witnesses. Bless us all, O Father. We firmly believe that all our prayers will be granted, because all of this we ask in the name of our Lord Christ Jesus. Amen. Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with us all, now and forever.
Amen.
Amen.
Palakpakan natin.
Ay, one, two.
Bye-bye. Ay, magbilang kape ha.
Thank you. nagsasalamat po sa iyo. At sa pagkain na aming tatanggapin ngayon, hinihiling po namin sa iyo na maanong pong paspasan mo, Ama, upang ito po ay makapagdulot ng lakas ng aming katawan para patuloy naming magamit sa mga paglilingkod sa iyo. Buo po ang aming pananampalataya. Dininig mo na po ang aming dalangin sa pangalan po ni Jesus na aming dakilang tagapagligtas. Amen.
Then without the table, I mean the red paper, it's nice.
Will be strong. Thank you. Congratulations.
Now, ladies and gentlemen, if you're still hungry, then go to the
thank you.
the ladies and gentlemen. So those who are married, can you please stand up? Married, the guests, not the guests, not the sponsors, just the guests. Four, no, married, again, I'm not married.
Thank you.
together.
Okay, it's Mary Chris. Yellow.
Good evening, good evening, good evening. Good very much. It's nice and it's wonderful. Would you like to take something?
Thank you very much for all of you welcoming me here from a foreign country. I truly feel as a member of the family, of course, as a member of the church. I want to thank you all. Thank you very much.
Thank you for the PMDK and the DJ man. Thank you also to the driver. I don't know who is the driver of the rental car, but I used to call him Raymart and Jack all over. Thank you for to all my flower girls and the ring bearer. And thank you also to myself, to my guest for coordinating my wedding. And to the guest companion, my guest. You should go up to your seat because there are two seats that has a silver ribbon. A silver ribbon. You only have a prize if you can have that. So if you will have the silver ribbon with me now, you can have a prize. So please go up to your seat. There are like two silver ribbons. So the RAQUEL and David, I hope you enjoy it. And this will be a very memorable one.
Thank you. on me. I wanna feel you in my arms again. To my bed.